Good evening and welcome to Living Holistically. We do global health. And I'd like to introduce myself. I am Dr. Linda Kareem, and this is Dr. Jimmy Pratt.
Hello, everybody.
And today we're going to talk about the things that we know that you want to learn about, because this is a sharing. We do this because we care. And so a woman's perspective is part of it. And
I guess we're in the other part. As a male, we have our part. Everybody has a part to play. And when you can come together and be on the same page, it makes a lot of difference. Make a man's work easier as well as the female.
It's like the nonverbal communication that takes place between two dancers.
Well, I dance merengue, I do salsa. Did I pronounce that right? Mm-hmm. I could never get that word right. But I enjoy dancing. And when you got a good partner on the floor, and when you see that partner, you always want to dance with that one particular person because they know your every move.
So, oh, that's because the dance is for the woman.
I'm the pitcher. Wait a minute. I'm trying to figure out how this thing goes. She's the pitcher, or I'm the pitcher, and do you remember how it goes?
Well, all I know is that it's so much fun when you have the backdrop of optimistic beat.
I know what it is. I'm the frame, and the female is the pitcher, because they do all the movements.
Absolutely. It's like ballet. Ballet is for the ballerina, and the male dancer is the framer.
Is it the matador?
Well, he supports the female in the intricate rhythm of life. And dancing is a very, very nonverbal communication between a male and a female. Nothing is said. Everything is intuited. And the male transmits to the female the move that he's going to make. Isn't that true?
That's true.
So he doesn't say anything. He just telegraphs, or he transmits the move through his hand, through his contact with her.
It's almost like NLP, which is neurolinguistics. It's body language. And you're actually reading that person's mind, in a sense.
You're reading that mind. You know, in traditional African dance, and we go to Easy Bumutu's Tuesday night classes where they have male drummers.
Yeah, and I beat the drums.
And he plays the drums.
Well, I plays them, rather.
And there are male and female dancers. Mm-hmm. And what makes this atmosphere so positive is the fact that the sisters have a certain move, and the brothers do something similar, but not exactly the way the female.
They got the male dance. You know.
They have the male dance. Yeah. So there are male dancers, and then there are female dancers. There are young girl dancers who are trained to follow the rhythm of the drum. If the drum beat is fast, then the feet are moving fast.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah. They're stepping high.
They're stepping high. So it's an exciting thing because dance class is training you to be an athlete, to be absorb the rhythm of the drum beat, and you don't have to teach a baby how to dance.
You know, okay, so you're dancing and you're moving your body, you're building yourself up, not just physically, but also mentally, because
right.
you have to know those moves, and you have to know your next move before
mm-hmm.
you go into it. So if you have some ailment, for instance,
mm-hmm.
you go out and you start dancing, and before you know it, you just kind of walk up and walk away from whatever is ailing you.
Right, because there are two diseases in the world. One is stagnation, and there's the remedy, which is circulation. All right. And so there's something to be said about boosting up your immune system and then following the cues of the lead dancers, following the cues of the teacher, following the cues of people around you in response to the drum rhythm. Now, we know that in traditional indigenous societies, this is the place where a unity takes place, where you can get rid of your, like you said, your aches and pains.
Absolutely.
Your attitude.
You can dance right on and walk away from it.
Your sadness, your depression.
Because everybody in that place was happy on Tuesday nights.
And you continue to be happy all week long until you go back to another class. Sometimes that happiness, those oxytocins, those chemicals that's released in the brain, last you about 2 weeks, right?
It does. I play the drums.
Mm-hmm.
But to see the smile and how happy those young ladies and the young fellows
mm-hmm.
are, you know, it makes a difference, because I can see them coming back week after week after week just to get back into their rhythm.
And then to meet new people.
Right.
Because then you find people from various social, economic conditions.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have some people who are very, very, women who are really, really teeny and skinny.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have sisters who are not skinny, but they can move better than you could ever imagine. You know, but spreading this happiness and joy is one of the things that living holistically and looking at global health, we want to encourage you to go to dance classes. They're not really classes. Go to your African dance classes so that opportunities can abound in terms of health and mental health and self-esteem and body performance. Because in the beginning of the classes, they have
yoga.
They have an African yoga stretch.
And we call it African yoga, African dance, because we have the African drums. However, you do not have to be African to participate, because it's a universal language. Dancing is for everybody. So come on out and have some fun.
And drumming is for everybody.
Yeah, absolutely. Bring your drum. Yeah. If you got a djembe, bring it with you.
A djembe or kungas,
yeah.
or...
Mm-hmm.
Any drum, you know, that takes you back to a place where happiness in the village. Now, we might live in a city or town, but when you enter the room where African dancing is taking place, then... you have re-entered the village of your mind. And then there are people from all ethnic groups.
Yes.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
From all over the world.
And people of all ages.
So if you have a child that is not a handicap, they can dance too, just like you.
Mm-hmm.
Bring them with you and enjoy yourself. Tuesday nights at 6 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
It's downtown Richmond, Main Street.
418 East Main Street.
418 East Main Street. Nobody, just come and have some fun.
And fun is one of those things that have no side effects, only it just put a sparkle in your eye and it rejuvenates you.
Well, that is the side effect.
Oh, yeah, it is a side effect, but it has no negative side effects.
No negative side effects. You get nothing but happiness and joy and peace.
Mm-hmm.
Peace of mind.
And wear something comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're just celebrating the end part of African History Month. And it's a very, very good time to promote those things because even churches now are inviting African dancers into their services.
Mm-hmm.
To integrate the sense of culture and history into their worship service. So, you know, I think that they would be open if your heart is open so that you can bring this joy and happiness into the service and do some ancestral things. So today's topic was about male and female working together in harmony in the dance, in music,
mm-hmm.
in movement, and in sound. And so when large groups of people come together, when a group of people come together, they have in their minds an idea about how that coming together is going to turn out. Some peace. A lot of times people come together in for peace and happiness, but they are looking for also community support.
Yes.
All right.
And we all need that. We
mm-hmm.
need each other, and we need to communicate. Learn about what's going on around you, in and about your city, your
mm-hmm.
neighborhood,
mm-hmm.
your children. I mean, you know, just get involved. Don't just sit at home and become a couch potato. But
mm-hmm.
you can get out and do something and really, really enjoy yourself, and people can enjoy you.
And they see how you are doing.
Mm-hmm.
And if you need any kind of advice or social support, if you're shy, then, you know, automatically a village environment.
Yes.
Will help to bring out certain skills. If you're timid,
mm-hmm.
you know, or if you are going through something that you can't even mention to anybody, just coming into the group helps to improve the quality of how you feel about yourself. And so we like to talk about global and health and neurolinguistics. And tonight, we'd like to talk a little bit about the growing issue of parenting in such a positive way to bring out the best in your children. And there are some preconditions of setting the foundation for the future is in the health of the mother and the father.
Right. The mother has to be in good health as well as the father.
And the father has to be in good health.
And they have to set a good example for those children. You can't start when a child is 11 or 12 years old. You have to continuously help that child from childbirth. All the way up until they leave your home, and even after sometimes.
Even in the womb, there's a training. If the mother is well-nourished, she's hydrated, She has good food, good nutrition, good mental health, peace of mind, joy, and happiness. And sometimes it's wrapped up in the language. That's why we promote neurolinguistics, because neurolinguistics is the conversation between the mind and the body. So we have 100 trillion cells in the body. We have a trillion cells in our physical body. And sometimes the bigger you are, the more cells you have in your body. But the cells in the body are communicating with each other. So we can say that the heart cells have a conversation. And the liver cells have a conversation. And they're working with the spleen, with the kidneys, mm-hmm. with the bones, and they all want to be on the same page. That is to save your life, right?
Right.
And you know when you're thirsty.
You drink some water, right?
You drink water. You don't drink, you don't look for that Fanta.
That Pepsi Cola.
Or that Pepsi Cola, because if you're a young person, even if you're always young. Let me set the record straight before somebody get upset. Because we speak a language. Upset means you're not settled. So let's get it right. We're as old as the universe and young as the moment. Everyone is ancient.
And everything starts from this point right here, right now, because see, you can't change the past. It's already done.
Right.
But the future, you can see your future. All you have to do is sit and decide what you're going to do.
Or how you gonna act?
Yeah, and it's up to you to do it. But you have to bring your mind together with your spirit in order to make it happen.
You gather yourself. All right. So, in indigenous societies, the male was a hunter. Right?
Right.
And the woman was the gatherer. Men aren't built for sitting.
We got to be doing something.
You have to be doing something.
Got to be moving.
Women are more built for sitting because they have something to sit on. But it's called nesting. Mm-hmm. Right? And everything in creation is set up with this male-female energy interacting with each other. So two alligators get together and they create more alligators. Mm-hmm. Kind according to its kind. And they have a language. All birds have a language. Lemurs have a language. Lemurs. Macaque monkeys have a language. And I want to just draw our attention to this example where there was a female macaque, a monkey in an experimental viewing where the female abused her male offspring. Continuously pushing him away, continuously screaming at him,
right,
until he got so timid that he would hover in the corner and wouldn't come out and play with the other little monkeys.
So he was hurt.
He was hurt.
And he didn't want to be in public. He was embarrassed because his feelings was hurt. And our children is very delicate when they're small. You have to really, really pay attention to them. Watch them, see what they're doing.
Because
they're watching you.
Right, they're looking for you, and they are highly imitative. So the first 1,000 days, 365 times three years where a lot of conditioning is taking place. The child is absolutely observing every move that you make. Not just you, just not like every move that's made by the person who is in that environment. But I just want to back up a little bit because there are some frightening facts about how the female, if there's a chemical imbalance in her chemistry and her hormones, and if she is on alcohol, drugs, over the counter, under the counter, unprescribed medication, abnormal eating habits.
So you have to love yourself before anybody else will love you the way you want to be loved. So if you're out there smoking, drinking, doing drugs, and your child, I mean, they're very impressionable in these first 3 years. So that's important. Whatever they see you do, at some point in their life, they're going to do the same thing.
Well, they have that in their memory.
Right.
You know, and the conscience of a child comes from the voice of the mother or the father. Mm-hmm. So it says, honor your father and mother, mm-hmm. that your days will be long upon the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. So, and when the child comes into compliance with honoring the mother and the father, the mother and the father, the originators of the child, there has to be a good role model. And there are two words that I'm going to use. One is called a prefect, right? Mm-hmm. And a prefect is a good role model. Okay? And the good role model is even-tempered, mm-hmm. patient,
right.
kind, considerate, and dependable. Has a good response in all situations. And gives a sense of safety for the child. The child feels safe and secure. So that's a prefect. That's somebody who has already gathered themselves. And they have a central core. They just don't perform well as a model. And then do the opposite when they're at home. All right. So the language of the mind works like this. Anything, any good thing that you say generates after its own kind. Every word held in mind reproduces after its own kind. Every good word generates a good feeling to the 1 trillion cells in the body, and it all comes online. And you have a good immune system. But what happens when you're cursing every third word?
Your child will be cursing.
It lowers your intelligence.
Yeah, they're going to curse the same way. You know, as they get older and older, they're going to become you.
Oh, that's
looking at themselves. When they see you, they're looking at themselves.
And then they're going to repeat your vocabulary.
Yes. So you have to think about what you're saying, what you're doing, and how you want to raise your child. I know you love them. Otherwise, you wouldn't have brought them into this world. So if you're doing all these things, and I mean, we can't tell you here how to raise your child. And we're not trying to, just here to make suggestions as, you know, what works and what have worked in the past.
According to neurolinguistics, the language of the mind, there is an old proverb that says everything responds to praise.
Mm-hmm. And when you want to get things done, let's say, if you want to make things happen, you have to get yourself straight first. And your child will follow you all through your life, and they will love you, and they will, if you're good, they're going to love you if you're bad. But you want to make sure that you're good and that you set a good example for your child, and you want to see your child be the best that they can be, then you have to make some moves on yourself. Make sure that you are moving in the right direction.
Well, health and safety is number one.
Mm-hmm.
So the universal law for health and safety is save yourself at all costs.
Yeah.
So if someone is in a threatening situation, mm-hmm. you know, no one is saying that you need to stay in a challenging situation where your health and safety is at risk,
right.
or your child is at risk. No one is saying that. We're saying that there are things that we can do to tighten up the give and take response in an intimate relationship. So we just had Valentine's Day
mm-hmm.
was yesterday. But originally, Valentine's Day was not based on St. Valentine.
Mm.
I mean, it's a nice story.
Tell me more.
And then you have the icon brand of a red heart. And if you look at the heart isn't shaped like a Valentine. It's not.
Okay.
And the whole idea for giving chocolate is a marketing strategy.
Mm.
Flowers and gifts is also.
The chocolate is good.
Chocolate is good. But that's not the reason why in antiquity the indigenous people were stargazers. And right now, if you look at the stars, there's a star system called Betelgeuse. And Betelgeuse is Orion's belt and the form of the archer, which is Cupid.
Mm.
But it's a dramatized star system that we use as a holiday for down here on Earth.
Right.
For the marketeers. So Hershey has cocoa plantations in Ghana,
mm-hmm.
all along West Africa.
Right.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And they are bringing in tons of cocoa, where chocolate is coming from by the tons in containers, and they're not waiting to do business yesterday. They have a concept design, and they are planning for Valentine's Day 2030.
Yeah.
Right?
Years in advance.
So, what was the original reason why this time of year was celebrated is because the original people of this planet used a star system to guide us to start
spring solstice?
The spring planting.
Yeah.
So if you have any land, You need to know. If you plant on time, you're going to get a good crop.
So you start preparing.
Remember when we planted those potatoes? And it was off schedule. And then we tried to go back and dig them up. Mm-hmm. And some potatoes were big.
Yeah.
And some, there were little bitty potatoes. But the earth was cooking potatoes.
They were still there.
And they were still there. And but still when there. You plant on time, you reap on time.
They stayed in the ground so long that they started to grow again.
They started another season.
They started another season, growing season, but it was plenty of potatoes under the ground once we started pulling them up.
So we have a motto that says, every word held in mind reproduces after its own kind. Yeah. Every seed that you plant in the mind, any thought at a certain time manifests itself. Right?
Yes.
According to the emotional state you're in.
So at some point it's going to show up.
It's going to show up. If you put in happy, you're going to get out happy.
It's going to look just like you.
Just like you. If you're going to put in health and you're going to invest in your health and your mental health, let's talk about investing in your mental health by being peaceful. And loving and kind, no matter what has happened in the past. Let's dissipate the past. And that's what you're so good at.
Well, what I do, when I get up in the morning, I meditate. I decide what I want to do for that day, who I'm going to meet. And before I meet this individual or this job or whatever the situation may be, I meditate, I pray, and meditation pretty much the same thing about what I'm planning on doing. So when I do arrive at the site or at the office or whatever, wherever I'm going, everything is smooth sailing. And then during the course of the day, and sometimes we get off track. And if we get off track, we get home at night, you don't want to go to bed with the with that thought in your mind, that every thought held in mind reproduces after its own kind. You don't want that to be in the back of your mind. You don't want to go to sleep on it. You want to meditate for about 10 minutes, clean that stuff out of your system, pray, meditate, get rid of it, and then have a good night's sleep. Get up the next day, you start all over again, and you get yourself going the same way. It become a routine. And not only just for yourself, once you can control yourself, your own mental state, then you know what goes inside of you and what you put inside will eventually at some point will start showing up. Your kids, your friends, everybody else will start seeing this, the person that you really is.
So the thing that we're looking at is the language of the mind. The mind wants to serve you because it's a tool. It is not the tool. It is a tool. And your language is your software program. Bill Gates has a company called Microsoft, which tells you that you can't walk around in life with a hammer. Do this, do that, do this, do that, do this, do that. It's not done like that. The biology is a very refined central nervous system that's taken billions of years to develop, and it is based on the intelligence of not just the mind itself, but also the body coming in sync and having the chemistry in order to be able to develop your dreams, hopes, and desires. Every word has power. So the positive words that you pre-program yourself with is something that's pre-programmed every second. You're programming yourself every moment. And the first three letters in moment is what?
Mom.
All right, now we're going into the moment. All right, this nurturing energy, that this software, this kindness, this gentleness, this reconditioning process, call meditation. You gently take yourself into peace and happiness, joy and love, and give that to yourself, a gift to yourself. It's a call of presence, right? We call it presence.
Right.
We call it a gift that you give yourself. Give yourself the opportunity to recreate yourself in the image and likeness of a peace that nothing can disturb. Then you have the base foundation for establishing a good relationship between you, yourself, and I as an integrated one system working with a whole mind, whole brain. And whole brain nutrition is that other piece that goes along with the neurolinguistics. But we have to be healthy, happy, and whole in order to move forward. Moving forward is guided by our language. Because once you get quiet enough, the real you begins to speak. Your internal guidance system, that still small voice that tells you anyway when you're doing good or you're not doing good.
And you know when you're not doing well, and you know when you're doing good.
And so you search for things to bring more goodness.
Yes. And you can do that through, I always say meditation, because that's when you get things done. You get to meet yourself. Right now we are, I guess, in the Bravo level of mind. Because when you go into Alpha is... it's when you're meditating, and then you can meditate on what you want to do. But nothing gets done until you meditate on it. And when you meditate, you're concentrating just on one thing. Whatever put before you, whatever you want to get done, you meditate on it, and you get it done. But when right now, you might say, well, I think I'm going to do something. Go downtown, and I'm going to paint the town red. And, you know, you don't always do what you say you're going to do. You never do everything you say you're going to do until you sit down and you think about it and you meditate about it. And then you get your spirit involved, and then things begin to happen, because that's how you get things done. Whether it's at work, or whatever the case may be, that's when things start happening for you.
Now, it's a thing to look at the neurolinguistics of what are you telling yourself. Most things don't go well if the language is not in divine order, which means that I'm going to bring myself into order. I am bringing myself into harmony. And I see what happens when my mind is agitated.
And when you get agitated, during the course of the day again, when you get home at night, guess what you got to do? I mean, we're going to repeat this over and over again until we get it. You have to sit down and you meditate and you clean yourself off. And you clean yourself off what we call things that bothers us. We call them samskaras.
Or impressions.
Impressions. The inside, and you have to delete that stuff from out of your system.
Dissipate the anger.
And let it go.
Dissipate the anxiety.
Or ask for forgiveness, depending on which way you pray.
Once you dissipate it, then you disconnect from that behavior. When you are noticing a whale under the water, it could be a whale.
Well, something you know you're not supposed to be doing.
And it's a lot of emotion. Yeah. It could be a crocodile. You might get ready to want to do a grievous act. That energy needs to be dissipated. And you dissipate it by going into the silence. Then the neurolinguistics comes in because you want to do better. You want to do something. You want to change behavior. You want to stop being abusive to yourself and others. But your language does not match your behavior. So every time you curse, or every time you dislike something, your intelligence diminishes. Every time you cut somebody out, every time you become impatient, and this is a program of how to misbehave.
I'll give you a good example. If you're riding down the street in your car, and you didn't lay somebody out because they cut you off. I mean, we're all guilty of it. But at some point, I mean, I do it right away because I want to get it out of my system. You have to forgive yourself and then forgive that person for cutting in front of you and get it out of your system. Get that anger out of your body. And it's the same thing as a samskara. When you meditating at night, you let it go again so it's completely gone. So you get up the next day with a fresh start and start over again. And then get your day started on the right track.
Because what's done is done.
Yeah.
And the universe, it does not protect or defend nor punish. It's perfect. It's perfect because everything that happens is based on cause and effect. That's why we say it's perfect, because it works perfectly every time. It's like mathematics.
Yeah.
If you get it right, you get it right. And the more you get it right, the more you want to do the right thing. So there's only two voices in the universe speaking. One is the voice of God that speaks to you and guides you, who should be the CEO of your corporation. And who's the other guy?
Well, we know this other guy, and he's not a good one. Was it kill, steal, and destroy? So he want to mess up everything that you work so hard to do to make yourself look good in the eyes of the Creator. But he want to drag you down, and he's there too. So you know you don't want this guy to pull you down. You want to keep moving in a positive direction.
So the enemy is
the devil, Satan,
in me,
in you. God is here, but Satan is here too.
So you want to make good choices, and perhaps you would like to develop a new vocabulary. If you say someone is getting on your nerve, there's nobody in your body but you, and you realize it's nobody but you, can you change you? Perhaps you're a go-getter. You want to make that $1 million. Well, you can't even control 1 million cells in your own body.
All that anger. When you get angry like that, your body, your liver has a memory.
Right.
And remember all the bad things.
All the details.
All the details on everything you ever done. And it can bring that stuff back to you. Mm-hmm. And those are what you call spiritual sins. When you do something or say something about somebody that is bad, and they cause physical sickness.
Only because of the toxicity of the thought process. Mm-hmm. So there are alkaline thoughts and then there are acidic thoughts. They're thoughts that are in harmony with universal consciousness, and then there are thoughts that are not in harmony with universal consciousness. There are thoughts that actually are deadly. Emotions rot the brain.
So you want to get rid of those bad emotions.
Your intelligence diminishes by 75% because you have an attitude. And not only that, you're repeating the behavior over and over and over again. And what we want to do is to assist you in recognizing the non-functional cognizant disorder or the dissonance. Who suffers the most? We all suffer from falling asleep at the wheel. So the wheel of life demands that we be actively alert, aware, and conscious of the energy that we are perpetually reseeding our mind, body, and spirit in a program.
So when you say falling asleep behind the wheel, is this something that you're conscious of that you didn't do?
It's just like, are you driving home and you've driven down this road so many times, you know every tree, every bump in the road, and so your mind goes on automatic.
So it's like going into alpha, and eventually.
Yeah, but you're unconscious. You don't know. I mean, you can become unconscious when someone has a trigger word that, you know, that reminds you of when your mother was displeased with you.
So you're driving down the road, and you get to from point A to point B, and then you think about, you know what, I don't even remember how I got here.
A lot of times we're doing things repetitively, and we're unconscious, we're running a program.
And you wake up, you're like in the hospital, you're like, wow, I don't know what happened.
Right.
Well, that's what happened.
What happened?
You go into a deep trance.
Or you could be a housewife or a dad, and the behavior of coming home being tired at the end of the day, you could have a flashback of how you used to come home and your mom and daddy was fighting, which caused you that smell, that odor, would cause you to go into that depression, and you're running a program, and then your wife said, well, what's the matter? And you say, I don't know. You know? Those kind of programs need to be reviewed and dissipated. They are in and a part of us. Neurolinguistics develops a language wherein we can go into our own system and dismantle and disconnect all of those things. Sometimes you need help. That's what Dr. Jimmy specializes in. You know, so if it's tobacco cessation, or overeating or phobias or fears. Mm-hmm. The reality of generating your own company, understanding how corporations work. You know, there's a corporation called the Roman Curia. Do you know what that is? Oh.
No, I didn't.
It's called the Holy See.
Yeah.
So this is an organization that has full and immediate control over every corporation there is on this globe.
Hmm. Where are they located?
At the Vatican.
Okay.
And they have control over all corporate entities. A nonprofit, 501c3, every corporation on this planet. This is why we're talking about being global and natural. And so, you know, we have these systems in place. We want growth and development. We want intellectual growth and development. But sometimes you can have pre-existing programs that redirect you away from your success. And those programs are big obstacles, especially for indigenous people. So we're here to put you in touch with this natural global consciousness that is not based on a piece of paper. A lot of corporations are based on paper. But we know that the planet belongs to the indigenous people, not the paper. When the indigenous people come back to their original mindset, after they pick up the ball, they drop the ball.
Mm-hmm. Hmm? It's just like falling asleep behind the wheel. It's something that you were supposed to have done and that you didn't get done. You dropped the ball. So, oops, I can go and do it now, but you know, you knew that you were supposed to have done it before.
But there's nothing more important than now.
Right. You can still do it. You have time.
Right. And the chemistry of now is what is required. Mm-hmm. Because success and failure is based on chemistry. So if you're alkaline, you have a mental alkalinity, you cannot be tricked or manipulated. You can't be treated like a commodity. You cannot be hoodwinked. You cannot be misdirected. Internally, you know exactly what to do because you're listening to the voice of God. That's inside you.
Speaking to yourself.
And you also learn how
your higher self.
You're speaking to your higher self.
Mm-hmm.
So we welcome any commentary. Please stay tuned. We'll be back next week after. And we'll do a series of 10 shows in April. So I am pleased to have been able to dance with Jimmy tonight.
This also dancing.
So we have a communication system where we respect each other, and he lets me do a lot of talking. This and it really is good. And
well, don't have a choice. No, I just kidding. But anyway, Linda loves to talk, and I enjoy listening to her talk. She has a wealth of knowledge, and it expands not just here, it's global. So she is hardly anything that you can, or subject that you can bring up that she don't know a little bit or a whole lot about. So, you know, I enjoy sitting and just talking to her and just digging that information out of her as much as I can get, any and often as I can.
Yeah, there's a gold mine in them there hills. And so we want to share our knowledge with the community because you all have talents and skills. You all have intellectual properties. Don't give them away. Develop them. And we'll be back. And we hope that you enjoyed this show, because we sure did. Continue to live holistically 365 days a year for the rest of eternity.